and welcome to this session. In this video, I discuss the last 12 month data, why they are important, and how we can compute them. I also use financial statements from Facebook to apply the idea to compute the last 12 month earnings per share. And we finally use that earnings per share to compute the relevant PE ratio for Facebook. It's worth mentioning that you may see LTM or TTM acronyms both referring to the last 12 month data. LTM stands for the last 12 month and TTM stands for trailing 12 month data. For example, if you check Yahoo Finance website, you see that in front of the earnings per share reported is mentioned TTM, and this is telling you that it's the trailing 12 month or last 12 month earnings per share, what we are going to compute, in fact, in this session. Now let's get started. Assume a company that its fiscal year ends on December 31st, and now we are in November, in the middle of the fourth quarter. Now, you're trying to compute the PE ratio for this firm to be used in your multiple valuation. As a reminder, the PE ratio is computed by dividing the price per share to the earnings per share. The price is the current price that you can observe in the market. Ideally, we would have loved to have earnings exactly for the past 365 days, which is one whole year. However, earnings are accounting numbers that are not available in daily or weekly frequencies. Instead, earnings are reported in companies' accounting statements, which are typically either at yearly or quarterly frequencies. Given that we do not have the ideal earnings we would have loved to have, what we should be looking for is an appropriate, reliable and most up-to-date number related to the earnings of the company. The most straightforward way is to go to the most recent annual filing and get the earnings per share from there to be used in the denominator of your PE ratio. The problem with this one is that the number could be too old. For example, now that we are in November 2020, the most recent annual filing is in 2019 filing that reports the earnings per share for the year ending December 2019. As a result, it does not take into account anything that has happened to the earnings of the company the past 9 or 10 months. This is particularly troubling in years like this year that earnings have changed dramatically compared to the last year. Earnings of some firms like Zoom and many online retailers, for example, have exploded, whereas many other companies have lost huge part of their earnings due to the COVID shock. As a result, if you use earnings from the most recent annual filing to construct your PE ratio and do your multiple valuation using that ratio, you end up concluding that companies like Zoom are surely overpriced. On the other hand, if you use earnings from last year for companies that have been negatively affected by COVID, like airlines, you would think that their PE ratio is too low since the price have dropped significantly for them, but we're still using last year earnings in the denominator, which are not relevant for today. The bottom line is that many things could have happened since the last annual filing, especially if you are already several quarters away from that last annual filing. To fix this issue, we should compute the LTM figures like the last 12 month earnings per share. The last 12 month earnings per share is the sum of the previous 4 quarters earnings per shares. Of course, when the most recent quarter is the fourth quarter of the company's fiscal year, there is no need to compute the LTM numbers since the LTM number is equal to the number in the annual filing. So now, let's go and see how we can compute the LTM data. Imagine we are in November 2020 and the most recent quarterly filing is for the third quarter. We want to compute the last 12 month numbers, for example, the last 12 month for earnings per share. This means that we need earnings per share for the period that includes the first three quarters of 2020 plus the last quarter of 2019. To compute this, we do the following. We get the data for year 2019. We add up to that the first three quarters of 2020. This gives us the data for quarter 1, 2019, till quarter 3, 2020. If I deduct the earnings for the first three quarters of 2019, it gives me the LTM data for earnings. So the LTM numbers are computed by summing the data for the prior fiscal year and the year-to-date data for the current year and deducting the year-to-date data for prior year. Sometimes current year-to-date data is referred to as current stock. Regardless of where in the fiscal year you are, you need only two filings from the company to do your computations for the LTM numbers. You need to have the most recent annual filings. In our example, is the annual filings for 2019. You also need the most recent quarterly filing. In our example, is going to be the third quarterly filings. The quarterly filing, you get both the year-to-date data for this year and the prior year. So both the blue and the red numbers here will be found in the quarterly filings. Now that we know how this works in theory, let's go and do it actually for the case of Facebook. We are now in November 2020. I need the annual filings for 2019 and the third quarter filings in 2020 for Facebook. I have looked them up. This is the 2019 annual filings. I need to look up financial statements. And within that, I need to go to the income statement to find out the earnings per share number for 2019. I use the diluted earnings per share numbers that account for not only the number of shares outstanding, but also the dilution coming from stock-based compensations and the like. We have another video specifically discussing the dilutionary effect of stock-based compensation that you could watch in this channel. In any case, the earnings per share for 2019 is $6.43, as you can see. Now, I need to go to check the third quarterly filings of 2020, which is a 10Q filing for the period ended September 30th, 2020. Here again, I look up financial statements and go to the income statement. Here it is. In this statement, as you can see, I have earnings per share numbers for both the first three quarters of 2020 and the first three quarters of 2019. As you can see, the earnings per share for the first three quarters of 2020 is $6.22, and this number for 2019 is $3.87. Now, I have all the three numbers I needed to compute the LTM earnings per share for Facebook. Now we can go back to our formula. The last 12 months earnings per share would be the earnings per share for 2019 plus the earnings per share for the first three quarters of 2020 minus earnings per share for the first three quarters of 2019. This gives us the diluted earnings per share of $8.78. With this, I can in fact compute the PE ratio for Facebook. The price per share today is $285 per share. If we divide the price per share to the diluted earnings per share for the last 12 months that we computed, we get the price earning ratio of 32.46. What we just computed is one out of several variations of the PE ratio, which is called the trailing PE or the trailing 12 month or the TTM PE ratio. So to summarize, we typically use a measure of earnings from company to use as denominator in multiples such as the PE ratio. I discussed that one of the best practices is to use the LTM earnings to reflect all available accounting information from the most recent four quarters. I discussed how to compute it, and I used the method to find the last 12 month earnings per share and the trailing PE for Facebook. I hope this was useful for you, and thank you for watching.